My game finally feels amazing to play. I got all sorts of new cool stuff in the combat system, and today I'm here to present some of them to you. Hey guys, it's Adrian again. I'm back with more updates of my PyGame RPG Ork Slayer. With 1 month's work, I proceeded from version 0.49 to 0.54. What does this mean? Well, there are a lot of new stuff, as well as old features revisited. This video would be way too long for all of them, so let's see the half of these features. Back in the older versions, the scheme was like, you select the character, read some story, fight, gather loot, check the character and inventory screen, maybe go to shop, then it starts again. But I realized that I put this game to not so solid foundations, so I basically had to start again and redo almost everything. And I'm glad that now the battle screen got some amazing redemption. So let's see. If you watch my last devlogs, you probably know that I had to rearrange stuff on the game screen to the new initial resolution, which is 320 by 180. This one fits well for this pixel art style and is comfortable for me to draw onto. So the first thing to do was this boring and painful rescaling and redrawing. It went kinda fast, thankfully, except this. So I could focus on regaining control of the choices on the screen. I got rid of the old cursor and replaced it with the cool color shifting text that may be familiar for you. Guess what? I have a tutorial about this. Wow. Now comes the fun part. The next thing to do was to bring back and rearrange the health and mana bars. I'll talk about a cool feature a bit later. First, I wanted to spice up these indicators. How? With particles! Yeah, finally I figured out how to make cool particles in PyGame. My first idea was that both bars should have bubbles in them that float upwards. Then I was thinking mana should be somewhat energy-like, so I've came up with a better idea. While the health bar has bubbles in it, the mana bar should have this nice zigzagging effect, somewhat resembling the flow of energy. But we're not done yet! Let's spice it up more! Let's make these particles follow the amount of stuff in the whole bar. I had the bright idea that the number of bubbles should correspond to the health ratio, but in reverse. This creates the illusion of boiling blood, basically more adrenaline as we're closer to death. Then I thought about this mana energy and I was like, it's channeling the hero. Let's make it flow faster the more mana we have. And here it is. Not joking, I'm really proud of these visual effects, since I had no reference to these and they came out of my head. Whew, okay, now let's move on to something really exciting. The next big thing I wanted to achieve in Ork Slayer is speed-based battles. I started this game as a turn-based RPG, but that's kinda lame for me, I had bigger ambitions. Speed-based battles work similar, yet they are more unpredictable. Every character has a speed value that determines when they can use their turn. So if I have 5 speed and you have 10 speed, you can use 2 turns while I can only use 1. These mechanics let me bring more strategy and risk to the battles as they will be more chaotic. And yo, I'm all in for that chaos, dude. So to indicate the speed stuff, I've made a speed bar on the top of the screen. The red men are quicker than the warrior, so they reach the end faster and can attack more often. First, I only use rectangles as markers, later I've changed them to the heads of the characters. And to make use of this new system, it was finally time to redraw the Redman sprite to match the hero sprite in animation length and color palette. I wanted to reshape its face and recolor it a bit, and now I'm satisfied. For now, maybe.
Psych!
To make it feel more real, I made the characters start their idle animations on different beats, so they won't bounce all at once. This just feels more natural.
Attention to details!
If you remember, the health bar had a pretty cool effect, but it gradually decreased upon the hero being hit. And now I finally brought back this effect. What's even better, that the time only starts to pass again in the game when this effect is over. In my recent 1 year video and also the trailer, you had the chance to hear the soundtrack of the game. It's not a big deal, but I've also solved the music playing problems in this never-ending deadly jungle I call my game script. Speaking of which, then came the big shit. No, not big, huge. I had all kinds of different subscreens in the battle, like inventory, skills, attacking, etc., saved as subclasses. This is a big problem since 1. It's plain bullshit. 2. When switching between these, it causes a bit of time lag, and this lag screws up the animations, so I had to unite all these subclasses into the main battle class. Thankfully, now I'm more experienced in Python, so I've reduced the length of the battle from 2500 to 500, though with all the new features it's around 1000 now. Quite a ride, I must say. So I had to make one controller function, one text displaying function, etc. out of this madness, with specific conditions of course, but it's much better now. And here comes the last bit of this video, which is also an
attention to detail.
I've implemented a feature that basically delays the actual attack to the exact keyframe where the peak of the attacking animation is. Now say this fast 3 times in a row. Cool, huh? So basically the damage is calculated and the sound is played exactly when this pesky little vermin pokes you with its spear. Man, I love small details like this. So yeah, I hope you could follow along. Next time I'll talk about how I use PyGame to draw outlines and masks, how I implemented smarter indicators, then we'll look into the healing, the death scenarios, and the new loot screen. So there's a lot to come, and even more than you know yet. If you want to support me, please leave a like and subscribe. Also share your thoughts about these updates in the comment section. Thanks a lot guys, see you soon, stay safe and take care.